Hey guys, today I wanted to show you what you're gonna miss if you do use a lot of VST plugins in your projects and don't use Bitwig. And we start off by adding one instrument track. On this instrument track, you can of course add Bitwig devices like the Polysynth. And these devices, like every device in Bitwig, has this little symbol down here where you can show the modulator lane, and you can add, of course, modulators. With these modulators, you can modulate each parameter inside the device like this. And of course, you can add multiple modulators and can route this modulator maybe into this, so you can come up with pretty complex patterns and modulation curves like you can see here. And the best thing about this is that this is also working for VST plugins, for instance the FM8. Let me come up with some basic patch here. And down here you see all kinds of available parameters for your modulation targets, and you can search for it in here. But the best way is just to touch the parameter inside the VST like this. And these last touched parameters are is shown at the top in here. So touch this, look at here. This is the parameter. Unfold the modulation lane, add one classic LFO, hit this, and now you are modulating this parameter. Of course, I've only touched the surface with the modulators and the VST inside Bitwig, but there are so much more modulators you can explore. For instance, the random modulator, which is a favorite of mine, where you can add subtle changes to all kinds of parameters and create breathing and living sounds. And the best thing is you can save the modulators combined with the VST as a preset inside Bitwig, and you can reload it every time you want it. So, and that's basically it for today. A short video about Bitwig and modulators. If you learned something new about Bitwig, leave me a like or hit the subscribe button. You also can support me via Patreon. And until next time, see you.